Welcome to my blog, which is called Electronic Waste Benefit. I've done a number of videos on this YouTube channel. The following video is on solar charge controllers. I refer to the video that I have done on the solar charge controller using PIC 16F819. This charge controller was using LED as indicators for the processes happening and the state of charge, the depth of discharge. So refer to this video for the next video that I am going to do, because everything is the same except the display that I have changed to 7 segment. So you remember, if you check on the video, I can just do a short simulation of it. You remember that I was using LEDs. So you remember this circuit, if you check, you will see that I've done a video on this circuit. So the following video refers to these ones. The only difference is these LEDs are not there anymore. We only have the 7-segment display, and everything else is the same. This video will include the PIC 16F819 and also the ATmega 8 microcontroller. So I've done for PIC 16F819 together with ATmega 8 AVR microcontroller. Also, I've included the PIC 16F88 because the 16F819 is almost full on the program space. So this is just for reference. And there is a schematic, because that one is only for simulation. So before we get into our discussion on our videos, I would like to get to this normal reading that we do, and the warnings that we help each other. Yeah, so please remember, safety comes first. So electricity can kill. You need experience in working with electricity. You need prior knowledge of electronics for you to do these projects. Keep all working environment and equipment out of reach of children. Expect that the age of the person doing this project be at least 10 years or above, although below might try under supervision. And please note, this is share, it's not an electronic lesson, so it's just a description how these circuits would work. The philosophy of the circuit is we use the recycled components as much as possible. Of course, if you can get microcontrollers as waste material, that will be okay. Otherwise, you can buy new components. And remember, please, you can buy everything new. It's just that you can also use the recycled components. And as always, it's there are better ways of doing what I've done. You can use your way if you get to do it will be easier than I have done it. You can correct it, because well, there will be mistakes in these circuits, of course. You can adapt it to suit what you want. You can modify, you can improve the circuits. Like for example, the solar charge controller, you can actually use the twin, you can actually modify it to. My intention was this be used as a training as training projects, and also as learning aid. Right. this circuit, of course, like I was saying, you can use it as a learning aid. You use it at home or actually as a working product for industrial production. I expected that maybe people will benefit from it. The required resources, you will need a computer, of course, the serial port, the 9-pin, or the laptop, the Microsoft Windows, or you can actually use the USB programmer, the PIC programmer, instead of the JDM that I have actually suggested here, for PIC-Kit 2 or PIC-Kit 3. You can also use the AVR programmer for the ArtMaker 8 project. You have to buy that one. I have not done a prototype for for the AVR, so I do not have suggestion how you can actually do it yourself. You will need power supply 18 volts, of course, for the PIC-Kit. For the PIC JDM. So I'll concentrate much more on the PIC other than the AVR, because I have not done the work on the AVR myself, but I have actually done just for the sake of those who would want to use the AVR. You need electronic components, of course, the ferroboard. Intend to use ferroboard or you breadboard or PCB or PCBs, you need components from there. Soldering iron, solder wire, of course, multimeter, and electronic tools, oscilloscope, maybe, logic analyzer, maybe if you have. Software, yes, you need software. You have to download the PIC programmer software, the PIC BGM, I suggest that one is very good, I've used it. The Proteus development, the suit that I'm actually using for simulation, you can download the trial version or you can buy one, or you can use another simulation software, because you just load your exe file. The LD Micro program that I've used, you need that one if you need to adjust and play around. It's a very good program, you can download it free from internet. Flow code, not for this project, although you can actually try to use it if you want, that's okay. Right, last but not least, you need time, patience, passion, dedication, and please feedback. You can feedback on taurimirim@gmail.com. I thank you and hope you enjoy electronics. So let's get to our circuits. I'll start off with the PIC 16F819 for the 7-segment simulation. Right, here you see that it's quite just a skeleton circuit, because you refer to the video that I've done for the PIC 16F819 solar charge controller, just using the LEDs as display. Right, these two outputs here will not be resistors, but an IC, a 7 Darlington transistor driver that I've used on the other circuit. So it's going to the ULN200304. Right, the other part is, okay, this is the solar supply, the solar supply for the battery charging, and also for the analog input to the microcontroller. And then here you also have the 5 volts here supply, which you actually have an analog input to the microcontroller here. The rest is basically the same if you refer to the video on the solar charge controller using the PIC 16F819. Right, this is also 16F819, but the difference is only on the display. And I'll give also the coding that I've done on the AOD micro program, and here's the battery, and here's the meter indication of the values that you can actually check. I'll give also this simulation for you to play around and configure the way you would want it. So the frequency that I'm running this microcontroller is 4 megahertz. You have to program whether you want the crystal source or an oscillator, outside oscillator, or you use the internal oscillator. Well, that can be done on the programming. Yeah, so here is how it works. I'll zoom it a bit so that you see. Right, when I start running it on the simulation, it will indicate here on these three middle LEDs of the 7-segment display. This is indicating the battery voltage. So this is state of charge, actually. This is the state of charge, or depth of discharge, if you like it. Well, the other one way or the other, it means the same. Right, okay. Now, so when it's full, all three are lit, and this is only shown when there is no solar, and when the solar is not present. That means here the voltage of the solar input side is risen to a certain value that says, okay, now there is no solar, so stop trying to charge the battery. So you can see that here the MOSFET drivers is off. Blue means it's off, red means it's on, it's high. Right, so here is the battery voltage. So if I change the battery voltage, let's say yes, the voltage of the battery, because this is the analog input to the microcontroller that actually checks the battery voltage, pin number 18, A1. So it shows the battery voltage. So this battery is now full. If I go down, it will actually also indicate. Sorry, let me use this. It goes down. Okay, this is faster a bit. Right. It's flashing, of course. Yes, yeah. Was at a certain, when it reaches a certain value of voltage, it starts to flash to say the battery is now getting empty. Right. So this is a flat battery, almost 1/3 of the voltage. Okay. These values, remember from the previous video, the values are actually set. You actually set these values. For the voltage given, you divide the 5 volts by 1023. You can divide by 1024. There is that confusion of people, but I believe it should be 1023, because there are 1023 steps that you have to take to get to 5 volts. It's a 10-bit analog to digital converter, so that's 1023 steps. Right, of course 1024 points, that is units, 1024, the other value is actually zero, so you have 1023 steps. That's why I have to divide by 1023. 5 divided by 1023. The difference is minimal. The argument doesn't really matter. We are not sending a spaceship to the moon, so the accuracy is good enough. So it gets to a point where it starts to flash with a certain value. Okay, it starts to flash. Say your battery is really now empty, and then. That's really saying your battery is really empty. It's flashing. So this is how it is displayed when there is no solar. Right. Suppose the solar comes which means there is certain value here that you set to say, okay, there is solar. Right, it comes when the battery was really empty. It says there's an error. The E represents error. You must check the battery. The battery is too flat. You can't charge it until it gets to a certain value. Then at that value, it goes to boost. Okay, let's say it was just flashing. When there is solar, it gets to a point where it will start to change. You can play around with this. Okay, you will see the values, and then you can calculate using the calculation that I have indicated on the previous video. You calculate by getting this voltage here, and then you get the units. After getting the units, you get your what voltage it actually has to change to boost, to charge to boost, and then it charges to boost until it gets to a certain voltage, which gives you an A. An A means absorption. It gets to a point where it's now on the absorption. Absorption is done to actually try to equalize the cells. It maintains 14.5, 14.7, depending on the manufacturer's recommendation, the battery manufacturer's recommendation. So absorption stage, and then it stays there. You would actually change this value if you want on the program, how many hours it has to stay on the absorption stage. 1 hour, 2 hours is enough. Between 1 and 2 hours is enough for most batteries. So it stays there until some time, until 1 hour, when it goes to float, and it will show you an F there to say it is now on float. I'll show you on the AVR program, when we are doing the AVR program simulation. Is when it goes to float, it shows an F there. So this is how it works. And this dot here, the decimal point, is actually showing that it is charging. That's charging. So it goes there. Suppose the solar goes, it waits for some seconds. It waits for some seconds before it actually switches off. Here it definitely switches off. Okay, right. So when the solar goes, it shows these three bars, because now there's no solar, so it goes to battery indication, state of charge. So the battery will actually be full, and then as the battery gets depleted, if you are using the battery, you will see that it goes to 2 bars, and then from 2 bars goes to 1 bar, and then after 1 bar it goes to flash. Okay, so well, the values of the voltages, you can change around, and I'll show you on the AVR simulation, because the AVR microcontroller that I've used is also a 10-bit analog to digital converter, so same like the PIC16F819. I've used the Atmega 8, the 28-pin microcontroller from Atmel. As you know now, Atmel is bought by Microchip. So, well, we hope great things will come out from there. Right, so now, this is our simulation for the PIC16F819. One other thing that you will see is that Okay, and let me bring back the solar here. So you see that these two will flash like I've indicated on the video for the LED display. It's just to test whether the solar is there or the sun is there, is shining. So it will flash on off for just a fraction of a second, which you can actually adjust. I've just done this. I always design my charge controllers like this, so that the moment you take out the solar panel, the charge controller switches off the input to the from the solar module. Right, also here, this is what is called an analog opto coupler or analog opto sensor, and you can make your own like I have done on the first video on the solar charge control, or you can buy. I'll show you a data sheet for that. This is me get to the data sheet for that component that you can buy. Here's the data sheet. It's called a Vactro. They are called Vactros, made by that company. Still coming. So the, yeah, analog optical isolators or Vactros. This is a trade name, a trademark. These are the components that you can actually buy off the shelf. It's made by Peking Elmer Optoelectronics. What it is basically is just a light dependent resistor and an LED. So you are actually varying the resistance of that. So here is for our charge controller, solar module. The higher the voltage through a resistor here, the brighter the LED, so the lower the resistance there. So you're actually controlling on this one here, you're actually controlling this voltage here, and this is the analog input to the microcontroller. So it's checking here the value here, so that you actually control what happens. Here is a straight on and a straight on battery voltage. Right, why you have to use this is because this reference to the from the solar module side is different from the reference on the battery side, like you have seen on the previous video. The references are different because here you have actually a switch, MOSFET switches. So the 0 volt is different from that side. The battery is 0 and the solar negative is what you are controlling, so the references are different. So you have to use some form of isolation here, so that's why you have to use a Vactro, or you can make your own like I have done on the previous video. So please refer to it. So this is how it works. Basically same plus minus same program, but different display. The A is now writing letters. Put B for boost, and then it goes to absorption, and after absorption it goes to float. And I'll show you on the float side what happens. So this is for the PIC 16F819. It's plus minus the same with PIC 16F88, no difference. It's only that the 88 is much more space than this one, because this on the program it's completely like full. I think it's 98% if I remember very well. Okay, now we stop that one. We close. Save changes. Okay, maybe I save the changes. I go to the Atmega. This is the Atmega microcontroller. Okay, I'm trying to zoom it so that you see what is happening. Right, I would want to change something. Here is the code for the Atmega. Right, what I would want to change is this here, and this is what you can change. And these values are actually the analog one is actually the solar side input, and you can change around like here. It delays 5 seconds before it says okay, it's night time, so go to sleep. So this value here is actually the calculated value for the analog input to the microcontroller. And then what other? This analog 1-2 is actually the battery side input to the microcontroller. So you can change these values to suit the battery voltages or the battery specifications. And what is else? Yeah. So here is the analog 1 input. It starts when the solar is gone below that one. So the analog input less than or equal to that one. When it goes less than that, then it says there is now solar, so start. And here on 600, it's above. When it goes above 600, it means there's no solar, so stop trying to charge. Right, what else can you change? Okay, now before I change, I can just show you the program. Here is how I indicate on the 7 segment. The YA is the A, LED of the 7 segment. B, LED, C, LED, D up to G, LED. And here is internal relay, solar okay, when solar is okay. And then okay, absorption stage, internal relay, and well, I could have written some notes on it, but anyway, maybe you'll be able to read this program, because I just write them as I'm thinking about it. Right, okay, anyway, so what did I want to do? I want to change this time here. This is 3600 seconds, which means 1 hour, I think 1 hour. I want to change it to 10 seconds. Okay, I change the count to 10 seconds. So this is when it is gone on absorption, but when that is the value when it is gone on the absorption stage. Even if it goes down a bit, it will not go off the count. Okay, when it's going there, it starts to count. Okay, count set. It sets the count. Where's the counter? Where's the counter? Where's the counter? I don't know. Where's the counter? Yeah, it's the counter reset. Where's the counter? Counter, 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 counter. Okay, you can search for the counter. Okay, there is a counter somewhere. Okay. Right. Oh, here it is. Okay. Yeah, the count. Right. No, this is the output. anyway, okay, right. It will start to count with this 1 second pause. And this is running at 4 megahertz. Okay. This is running at 4 megahertz. And this at mega 8, you can just change the microcontroller to peak, and then you have to adjust the outputs and the inputs there. Right, okay, we have changed to 10 seconds so that we see the float. Because when it is an absorption, it starts to count until it reaches this count here, counted to 10, and then it goes to float. Right, so I am going to compile this one. Yes. Okay, I do it this way. That's for the video. That's the video here. Okay, and save. Right, that's what this program does, but anyway, no problem. Right, alright, compile this video. Okay, now, you should have compiled. Okay, where is the campaign? It is not compiled. Okay, maybe service. Save. Well, why you know, why complicate things? Okay, just compile. I compile it. Compile. So it compares to that. Okay. Anyway, I have to change it. If I don't change it, please change this 10 seconds to 3600 or whatever value you want. The at least 1 hour to 2 hours. Okay. How many seconds is that? You have to calculate. Okay. No problem. Right now, on that. Now I have to load that program here. This program, right? I have to load that one. Load that program. Remember, we compiled to on 10 seconds. And here, the settings. Please remember, reset, disable, unprogrammed. Okay, doesn't matter what software. Yeah, I had to play around here because it was giving me headache. Here, please remember to put frequency here when you actually do here something here. Put your frequency there, 4 megahertz. And then what is important here is the I'm using the external clock. And then please, maybe you are going to use the external clock. If you do not use the external clock, please clock option here. Leave it unprogrammed or programmed to internal clock if you want. The fuses, I don't know. All those settings, please. That's the difficult of working with the AVR. But anyway, this works. I've done it. Now, so this is this. Like I said, is this? It's just an option for the charge controller. You can use the peak. Or you can use the AVR. If you use the AVR, you will see that here the input side is the same, the module side plus minus the same. It's only the input that is different. Actually, you have the same setup, same resistance here, same LDR here, and you can buy the Vactro as I shown you. And then here, the battery side the same. You have your module side here, solar, 22 in, volt in. Here, output, same output from PB0 and PB1 going to the to drive the MOSFET if you want to use the UL N302003 or if you want to optocoupler, drive the optocouplers to drive the MOSFETs. However, you want to switch the MOSFETs, please refer to the PIC 16F819 solar charge controller using LEDs. Right here is the 7-segment display. Right now, I am going to run the simulation here. Sometimes it gives problems because I think it's a bit heavy on the AVR simulation. Right now, here I'm going to adjust it straight on that program. What I did was, if it goes beyond a certain value, it shows H, which means high voltage. Just like the peak version will also show you an H, which means high voltage. Okay, it's actually than that. When it goes beyond a certain value of voltage, it shows you the voltage now too high. So it shows you high voltage. The H means high voltage. You have exceeded the voltage, or the battery voltage is too high, or whatever. So it's actually a warning sign. So it must go on absorption for 10 seconds. Plus minus if it's running, okay. The correct timing to should go. Okay, 10 seconds should not be that long. Okay, I see what's happening. Okay, it has stopped charging. Okay, when it is stopped charging there, it will not go to float. you must go down to a point where it is on absorption and charging.
Okay.
It must go on absorption and charging there. So it gets to a point where it goes to absorption and then stops charging. And when it stops charging, it stops counting because it's not charging. So it can't go on float when it's not charging because, well, it has stopped charging. So we'll wait 10 seconds from here now. Yeah, okay. Yes, now it goes to float. You can see now it goes to float. That's good. And then when it goes to float, it stays on float until it gets to a certain value, then it goes to boost again. A certain value of the battery goes to boost, and then it goes up, gets to a point where it goes to absorption, starts the process again. Or when it is on float, if the solar goes out and then it comes back, it starts the process. Right, okay, this is simulation, so we have to actually simulate the proper conditions. Proper conditions must be simulated. So if you go the float, okay. If the solar goes away, obviously the battery must go down. For float goes to float. So if the solar goes away, what happens to float? The solar goes away, what happens to float? Let's see about that. Right, goes down. Okay, so this is how it works. Yeah, maybe I change before I forget. 3600 seconds, right? Maybe I must. Did I stop? No, I didn't stop. Okay, I must stop that one. Okay, I must stop that one. And then, okay, I save that one. Compile. You see this chip is now 97% full and the RAM is only 2%. That's why you have to maybe think about using the Mega 168, the 16 kilobyte Atmega AVR. But 97 should be okay for this program. Okay, so I've changed to 3600. Yeah, I'm shutting down everything. Anyway, okay, right. So I think this is plus minus about it. And I thank you for your time. And I hope you enjoy this. And hope you give me feedback to it. And the feedback is taurainirimi@gmail.com. And my next video will be on solar charged LED lamp. So for this, I think it's done for solar. My solar passion, my newfound passion. Until maybe if I can design the maximum power point tracker, charge controller. Well, that will be a lot of work. But anyway, for this one, it's okay. Thank you very much, and God bless. Bye.